From DailyDoseOfWeirdNews.com, I'm Darren Marlar, and this is your Daily Dose of Weird News. This episode is brought to you by the audiobook Your Haunted Lives – True Tales of the Paranormal by G. Michael Vasey, a collection of creepy, often downright chilling true experiences of the strange and weird that'll keep you looking over your shoulder. Hear a free sample and support Marlar House by downloading the audiobook for yourself at DailyDoseOfWeirdNews.com. A Florida lice treatment center says that selfies could be one of the major causes of lice with teens. Well, you know, I guess lice just like to photobomb people's pics. For decades, a 55-year-old woman in China has had an appetite for dirt. Her unusual habit began some 50 years ago when she got a taste while cleaning a family home. She estimates she has eaten now 5 tons of dirt. And even worse, it's Chinese dirt, meaning 20 minutes later, you're hungry to eat more of it. President Trump now admits there are no tapes of James Comey. Meanwhile, Comey confessed that he never DVR'd The Apprentice. A book of short stories titled 40 Minutes Late has been returned to a San Francisco library. 100 years late! Webb Johnson returned the book Friday, and there was no fine. Johnson's great-grandmother had checked it out in 1917. She passed away a week before the due date. Johnson found the 1909 book in an old steamer trunk in 1996. So maybe it wasn't great-grandma's fault, since she died before it was due. You found the book in 1996. You're just now returning it? 21 years after you found it? A couple from Ecuador claims that they have lived without eating food for 9 years, saying they live on just air. Looking for a new dining experience? In San Francisco, a place called The Dungeon has planned a 2-day experimental rat cafe for those who feel their coffee or tea is better sipped while rats, supplied by the local rat rescue, scurry about the room. Pastries are included for the $49.99 price, but the rats will be removed before the food comes. Guests are promised at least 15 minutes of rat interaction, and the price includes admission to The Dungeon. You're just in time. This all goes down July 1st and July 8th. Yum. There are rumors circulating around D.C. that Supreme Court Justice Anthony Kennedy is about to retire. The rumor started when he began showing up each morning wearing a fishing hat. An associate professor of English at an Ontario university lent her copy of a textbook to one of her students 5 years ago and never saw it again. That is, until she recently ordered a used replacement copy on Amazon. And her old copy arrived, complete with her name and the date written in her handwriting on the title page. Eugenia Zorowski said, "I was stunned." She notes that it's particularly uncanny because the book is about shopping practices and how consumer markets encourage us to feel closely attached to the things we buy. Good thing she was an English teacher and not teaching ethics, seeing as her student just stole her book and sold it online. Japan is in constant conflict over whether to beef up their military. As of late, increasing concerns about North Korea are fueling the fire, even though the country's constitution requires a low-profile military, only for purposes of self-defense. However, when the country's defense minister recently suggested placing females into combat roles, a constitutional law professor strongly objected. It's not the obvious sexism that got people talking, though. Rather, it was his reasoning for not wanting women in combat. He actually said that Japan's enemies might have bombs capable of blowing women's uniforms off, thus exposing their bodies. Don't worry, the laughter and ridicule was swift. One critic wrote, "I think I saw something like that in Dragon Ball Z." A toddler in Massachusetts survived a 2-story fall from a building last Wednesday thanks to his stuffed animal. The 2-year-old boy of Chelsea was jumping on his bed when a hop sent him out his home window. Luckily, the boy was holding a large stuffed cow during the fall. He landed on the toy, which provided a cushion between him and the concrete sidewalk. You know, I had a cow save my life once. Yeah, I was starving, but I found a McDonald's just in time to grab a cheeseburger. An Algerian man picked a truly horrible way to satisfy his craving for attention, and now will get plenty of attention in prison. You've probably seen the now infamous photo posted by the unnamed man dangling a baby out of a 15th-story window of an apartment building in Algiers with the caption, "1,000 likes or I drop him." Well, social media users quickly denounced the photo, and police charged the man with endangering the life of a child when they arrested him on Sunday. The man, who is a cousin of the baby, swears the whole thing was a misunderstanding. The boy's father also said he believed the man was just being playful and asked the court for mercy. The court responded by sentencing the idiot to 2 years behind bars. Maybe you remember the story of 34-year-old Kelly Mason of Leicester, England. She had grown weary of her neighbor's kid's soccer ball constantly landing in her garden and, when it happened again, punctured the ball before throwing it back. The mother of the children, Natalie Bolin, and her father, William Jelly, responded by coming right over and beating Mrs. Mason to death. Well, the two murderers just found out their fate. They each got 7 years in prison. Bolin's lawyer said things had been boiling for a long time. Both women had filed complaints with police regarding the other, and his client simply snapped. He added the consequences were far beyond anything she could have imagined and is something she will be eternally ashamed of and will regret forever. However, the judge said neither Bolin nor Jelly showed any remorse for their actions. He said Bolin boasted about the assault to friends and seemed almost triumphant at Mason's death. And so you give them just 7 years? What? Despite experiencing the hottest June temperatures in more than 40 years, the head teacher at Iska Academy in Devon, England told boys shorts were not an acceptable part of the school uniform. However, she did not ban skirts. So, guess what happened next? Yep, dozens of boys at the secondary school turned up in skirts that they had borrowed from friends or siblings. One teen described the feeling as a nice breeze amid the sweltering temperatures. One mother, whose 14-year-old son attends the school, said children also don't like injustice. The boys see the female teachers in sandals and nice, cool skirts and tops, while they're wearing long trousers and shoes, and the older boys have to wear blazers. Boys who wore the school's regulation tartan skirts did not get into trouble. Well, except for the one who wore his too short. With the protest now spreading to other schools with bans on shorts, Mitchell has said she's ready to consider the school's dress code. Congratulations, boys! You stood up like real women and fought for equal rights for boys. Girl power! Ryan Seacrest is still trying to hammer out the final details for him hosting the next incarnation of American Idol. The current sticking point is that Ryan wants executive producer credit as part of his compensation. Lionel Richie won't supposedly sign on as a judge until Ryan is secured. Whoa, wait a minute. Lionel Richie? He's still alive? Kim Kardashian was the top bidder at an auction for a wristwatch once owned by Jackie Kennedy. All it took was $379,000. What do you need a watch for, Kimmy? Do you know what also tells time? That phone you keep taking selfies with. Oscar-winning filmmaker Ron Howard is stepping into a galaxy far, far away for the upcoming Star Wars Han Solo spin-off movie after the surprise departure of its directors. Man, who would have thought that back in 1977, when Star Wars was released in theaters, that the redhead kid on Happy Days, which was on television at that same time, would be directing a prequel to that movie 40 years later? In fact, who knew what a prequel even was back in 1977? Never miss a single episode of the Daily Dose of Weird News. Download the free Marler House mobile app. In the app, you can find links to my Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Watch other Marler House YouTube videos. Sign up for the Marler Sheet newsletter to automatically be registered for giveaways. Purchase Daily Dose of Weird News t-shirts or mugs. Download audiobooks I've narrated. See my latest blog posts and more. The Marler House mobile app is free for iOS and Android users. Download it now by clicking the mobile app tab at dailydoseofweirdnews.com or search for Marler House in your phone app store. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and be sure to subscribe if you want to see more. And click that little bell icon next to the subscribe button to be notified when I post new videos. And if you're already an official weirdo, please share this video on your own social media. Find even more weird news that I didn't have time for on the Facebook page at DailyDoseOfWeirdNews.com. I'm Darren Marlar, and I'll see you next time, Weirdos!